and I sent my stuff just like handwritten, because I didn't have anything over there. I couldn't, no computer or anything in 92. Handwritten with some snapshots, and WCW called me in 2 days because I needed a tag team partner for Tom Zenk.
How were you contacted about going to WCW?
I get the call from Magnum TA. He tells me right off the bat, he goes, I don't know what name we're going to give you. It looks like, you know, you look like Tom Zenk. You're looking for a tag team partner for him.
Right.
So they flew me in, and it was easy being in a tag team. Zenk was already established. He was, you know, he was in the business. It just, he put a damper on things because he was so bitter.
Right.
I mean, to this day, he's, like, I don't know recently, but I mean, after wrestling, he politicked to no end about on websites, just bitter. He had his whipping boys, his Vince McMahon, his Dustin Rhodes, his Bill Watt. I mean, he had his 10 guys that he just never, ever, ever would let go.
Right. He said, I'm just going to ask about Tom Zenk. He said this about you and how you got into WCW on a radio show. He said about you, he said, he sent in photos of himself to the office. That's normal. What's not normal is that Bill Watts went up to all the female employees and showed them photos of you, asking, is this guy good looking? Is this guy good looking? And the women would say yes, and that's how Brandi got hired.
Well, that's good, though. I mean, I hope so, because it was more so that we had some resemblance. You want tag teams that have some kind of resemblance, even back then, today. You know, they try something a little bit different. But, yeah, I mean, that was the thing where he was just so bitter. I mean, I came in there with so much aspiration, so much excitement, so happy just to be there. It was my first time. He's a good 10 years older than me. I mean, he always looked good, you know. But Tom, he already went through the ringer with the Martel saga that will never go away, okay?
Right.
The Martel, all that dirty laundry that will never, ever, they were sleeping together and everything else. You know, that'll never go away, okay? The Buff Bagwell partnership, the Brian Pillman partnership. It was just one of those things where we were going to be a mid-level tag team. They know where you're going to be before you go in. That's the bottom line. They know how far you're going to get, and that's the bottom line. I think Zenk, telling Zenk this story, Zenk would be the one in the car when you're driving. He'd be the one doing the Dusty impersonation. That's the part that kept running through my head. Not hearing Dusty for the first time. Me telling Zenk, and Zenk saying it over and over again, where it just drilled in my head. But I like Tom. I really did. It's just such a shame at the part of his career that I met up with him. And he was just beyond bitter. And it just put a damper on things.
When you were tagging us with Tom Zenk and became friendly or whatever, did he ever tell you whatever happened with him and Martel?
No, he would never touch on it. He would never, ever touch on it. It's funny because I would never ask him point blank, but he would like again, it was just negativity. I mean, he would shoot Martel down to the point of he could say, oh, he was Pat's boy, or he was this guy's buddy's buddy. It was never anything positive. I mean, Tom left there. He made it like it was a financial thing was the reason. Okay, he was saying Martel got X, Y, and Z dollars. And they wanted Tom to do all the same stuff and all the same what level you are on the card. And I said, you know what, but where it came down to being anything where the rumors got out. To this day, like I said, Martel, he's always been straight with me. And you never know what happens behind closed doors. I'll call a fag in a second. I don't know, probably I'll get to Pat Patterson in a second. But again, with Zenk, it's just bitterness. It's just such a shame because I like Tom. It was just I wish I could have moved on with him to the point of, you know, even if like other federations, actually, which we did afterwards, but it was just, you know, again, he just looked at everything just miserable, miserable, and with the heavy like muscle relaxers and just, you know, what's been big in this business, the thing where I never fit in with the recreational drugs and with all the other stuff. I just said, God darn, he's.
How bad were politics in WCW?
Heavy. It was a lot heavier than WWE, if not the same. It was definitely jumped out. I mean, two guys. I mean, Dustin Rhodes, Herb Watts.
Right.
I mean, Zenk just beat it to death. I mean, I can still hear him in my ear just over and over. What's funny is, my first pay-per-view, now I think about it, WCW, was myself, Shane, and Tom Zenk. and it was in Philadelphia. This is at the height of the hardcore as ECW was growing, against probably the three most popular heels. I mean, this was, it was a kiss of death. It was Michael Hayes, Arn Anderson, and Bobby Eaton, okay? Talk about, thank God I was only in the company for about a month and a half or 2 months.
Right, right.
To where they couldn't hate me yet.
Right.
They knew I was from Philly, so they gave me a little bit of slack. They just beat the hell out of Zenk. And if anybody ever gets a chance to get that match on tape, you don't get the full effect from watching it. They had signs in the crowd, I'll never forget, Shane and when he was tag teamed with Johnny Ace as the Dynamic Dudes.
Right.
Oh my God, brutal. I mean, I went over, they put me over in the match. I took it on Michael Hayes. But, and again, you talk about the height of ECW hatred, the fans' hatred for the baby faces. I will never forget it, but thank God, again, it was Shane, which was a whipping boy at the time, and Zenk, which was a whipping boy. I just thank God that I wasn't yet.
Right. How did your tenure with WCW come to an end?
We were on a cut list. They probably got rid of about, just like that part's always be the same, about a dozen of us. We mentioned the Wrecking Crew, guys like that. Rob Van Dam left with an injury, and he wasn't anywhere obviously near what he is today. He was just like an up-and-comer. And again, he still did all the same moves. It was just, you know, we got a cut list saying, okay, I did WCW, now it's time to focus in on WWE. In the meantime, I got a job in All Japan, actually as Johnny Ace's tag team partner, even though like over there you're not like with that guy every night, up a lot. And it was all because Zenk fucked up. They won again. I was following Zenk's coattails. They wanted Zenk. Zenk had three strikes in All Japan. So they said, let's bring this guy that looks like him, was his partner in WCW. So I got four consecutive tours, which drove me crazy. I mean, I hated it. I mean, I'll be honest with you.